This is the Tesla valet card that I can use to start my car. So I'm going to dissolve it in acetone to get the chip out so I can take the chip to encapsulate it in a biopolymer and implant it in my hand and start my car. I've noticed they take about an hour to dissolve completely. They're a little bit heavier dutier than like a hotel room key. And the antenna goes around the perimeter of the card. So you can't just cut the card in half. These Tesla key cards have no unique identifier on the card at all. So you can buy any of these cards and you can program it to any of your Tesla Model 3. So the way the process works is you would take this card and you would tap it to your Model 3 and you want to write a new key and you use your master key. So people can't just randomly write a new card for you to start your car. A few years ago, I got this RFID implant in my hand. And it's just basic access control. If I were to tap my hand to your phone, it would automatically open a browser and go to my webpage. It also works with my front door, so it's just access control. And then I pre-ordered a Tesla Model 3 a few years ago, and I heard that the key card was actually gonna be an RFID-based technology to start the car. So I was like, oh, maybe I can get that information and store it to my chip and to be able to start my car. When I tried to scan and get all this information off the Tesla card, I was thinking, oh, hey, I can get a lot of information about the Java applet that it runs on, but I can't take that information and write it to my current chip. So it's pretty secure. Good job, Tesla. I was like, I'm just gonna take the chip that I have in my valet card and encapsulate it and implant that one in my hand. Amel is one of the person that started Dangerous Things. And the chip is very much similar. He went to like his vet, and it's the same chip to track for your dog. And he said, well, if it's safe enough for me, it's safe enough for my pet. So I kind of roped him into my Tesla hat because he's all this knowledge. And when I dissolved the chip, I sent it to him and he encapsulated it in biopolymer. Which is safe to use for the body and under the skin. Talked to a few doctors. They were a little weary about doing this because it's kind of a, you know, a questionable thing. End up finding a guy that does body modifications and things like that. He's very familiar with the process and sterilizing everything and the biopolymer and the flex and how it needs to be installed. If anyone is like a hardware hacker, they'll think this is ironic. The guy's name is Pineapple. So like the pineapple Wi-Fi sniffer, I'm gonna be having some guy named Pineapple install this chip in my hand that starts my car. They say like, oh, you can't like start your car with that. That's not secure, it won't work. And it makes me wanna do it more, and not more because they say, no, you can't do it and I wanna like defy them. It makes me question why. Like, why can't you do it that way? Like, what are the limitations? And it actually makes me research. It's to be able to reverse engineer it, understand how it works, why it works that way. And then at the end, it's like going to the candy store. You're like, I did it. It's like the sword of destiny. You're like, ah.